the motto of this contest, the Eurovision Song Contest in Malmö 2013, is "We Are One." What do you think of when you hear that motto?
I think we should be as one. Actually, I think the other countries should support each other, and even if we don't like the song, we should say it in a gentle way. The song, the dress, maybe, and we should be a very good power. We come to listen to good music. We shouldn't forget that we come for the music. That's what we love to do, and that's the reason why we are here. We are all here for the music, not for a dress, not for a show, not for the outfit, not for anything.
The dress is impressive. You have an impressive dress. No, but you know, my last question is, before I give the opportunity to our friends here to ask some questions, is this famous Eyal Golan, how important and how crucial has he been for you?
Eyal Golan, whoever don't know Eyal Golan is the most famous singer in Israel. He did a reality show where he was looking for a singer to promote, to host in his shows, and to make an album. I was the singer that he was looking for, actually. We are working 2 years together already. My first album is about to come out in a few days. He's like my second father, actually. He took me when I was a little girl, you know, 2 years ago in the army, and made me who I am today, and I have to thank him for everything. He's everything to me. I wouldn't get to here without his help.
Is he coming to the competition?
Of course he's coming.
Wow, great. Can I just ask you, you know, the glasses, it's not so common that artists wear glasses nowadays.
It's because if I take it off, I won't see a thing. I'm blind, okay?
No, I think it's very cool that you still wear glasses, because you don't see it so much these days in artists.
So, I have 6 pairs, so if you want.
Yeah, 6 pairs. Okay, great. Okay, so please, can we have a microphone over here?
Hi, Laura, I'm Torben Eck from the Swedish newspaper Aftonbladet. The Israeli delegation has the most security in Eurovision, and that's always the case. How is it for you to know that that comes just from the fact that you're from Israel? And second question, earlier today there was a bomb scare at your hotel. Are you ever afraid for your safety because you're from Israel?
Yes, with your permission I will answer that. Any security reasons we obviously cannot answer, but we feel very much secure here in Sweden, thanks to our security and of course the local police. About the scare, we've heard about it, but we know it wasn't anything serious, and again, we feel very much secure.
Absolutely, the dog
deserves off.
But my question is,
very nice dog, by the way.
Maura, yeah. Are you ever afraid of your safety?
No, ever.
You're not? I am.
No, I'm not. I know, I believe in God. You know, and I think I really believe in God. And I think God is his own yeah, I feel protected by God.
He's taking care of you.
Okay, yeah, that's all.
And we also have some Swedish policemen here.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, other questions, please. Here we have a question, and over there, our friend over there also.
My name's this on the air. My name is David Thielen. I'm from the United States, which makes me a minority here, running for Wee Wee Blogs. A question for you. I watched your rehearsal, and I'll have to admit it's the only rehearsal I watched. But, and I don't mean to denigrate your performance at all, I thought it was beautiful, but you're there and you're going through the second time, and you're going through the third time, and I got the feeling in a couple of minutes, okay, you have to do it as you're doing the cameras different ways and the lights different ways to catch all that right. Is there a concern that by the time you finally go up, and it's for real, that you've done this so many times, and at times you've walked through it because it was more about the camera than you emoting and everything, you're no longer going to give your best performance?
You know, we did it so many times because I don't want to get excited. And the rehearsals are for me to get to know the cameras and to get to know the people that are around me on stage. And the song is very exciting, and I'm excited to sing it each and every time. That's the reason I chose it. I think that once I get to the stage in Thursday, it won't be anything that I imagined. Once the audience will be in the arena watching me, and once I get to see my parents that are about to come in a few days, the feelings will be different, I'm sure.
Thank you. So, last two questions. The man in the black, where is the microphone? Black t-shirt, and then we have, we're so many. You can ask your questions later. Okay, please.
Shalom, my name is Marta. I'm from Vienna, Austria, for the newspaper Der Standard. First of all, let me thank you for bringing the best voice of this year's contest. My question is, my newspaper is quite political, so sorry that I'm asking a more political question, but was already mentioned. The Jewish community here in Malmo is suffering from a lot of anti-Semitism. And there will be a demonstration on Thursday where they say Israel should not join Eurovision, a ridiculous demonstration, how I think. But it's even supported by politicians who are governing the city. So how are your feelings about this? There also will be a demonstration on Saturday to show that there is anti-Semitism in the city. Will you support that one? I will go there, by the way.
Just one second. What do you mean it's supported by the city? I don't think it's supported by the
city. By members of the governing party of the city. By members of the governing party.
I'm pretty sure about that, but please answer.
I will answer that. Like Israel, Sweden is a democracy, and everybody has the right to protest and demonstrate. It's their choice. In my own opinion, I don't believe they're right, because yes, we're Israelis and we're representing Israel, but we're not necessarily representing the Israeli government, and you have to make that different between the two things. I wish they would have met with us and get to know us, because we're people. I don't think it would help them. We're in the contest. We will keep taking part in the Eurovision Song Contest. And I think that if they really want to help their brothers and sisters like us in the Gaza Strip or anything else, they should do other things, because I don't see that helping at all. And again, we're human beings and we're people, first of all, and then we're Israelis.
Yeah. So, you see, so many things. Let's keep in mind that this is not governments. No, it's not a contest for governments. And are you open to meet people and to talk with them?
Of course.
That's a great invitation. So, my friends, last questions here. We have one man in front. You have a question, second. So, please, can we have a microphone in front here? And then, of course, you will have the chance to ask more questions. And we also have a small surprise from the Israeli delegation. So, let's give it some time.
We've got the American guy here.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
Yes.
Hi. Hi. Everybody, they already know. I'm Leon. I'm from Mako, COIL from Israel. And Roman, first of all, great rehearsal. You're looking damn fabulous. I wanted to know more about the album, when it's coming out, about the type of the songs, and if it's possible to hear something else, some other song apart from your new album.
Okay. So first of all,
yes.
You wanted to say anything?
No, I just wanted to give you the opportunity to give us something extra if you want.
She will.
I will, first of all, but the name of my album is Rag Bishvilo, very surprisingly. In the album you can find Rag Bishvilo in two versions, the version of the Eurovision, and in the CD version. In my album you can find songs that are similar to Rag Bishvilo, that reminds Rag Bishvilo. And you can find more ethnic songs. Ethnic music is very popular in Israel. So that's what you can find. If you want me to sing you something, I will.
Yes, please.
Everybody can hear me?
Yes.
The name of the song is Shalhuti. It means they sent me. Chen Metzger also did the arrangement. And we have the song, the writer of the song and the composer of the song, Doron Madali. Hello. And that's a little